Hey, welcome back. It's another Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. This is the last of the Vlookup week. Thought it'd be appropriate to go back and look at the very beginning, the origins of Lookup. So here I am in VisiCalc. This is basically version one of VisiCalc from 1979. They only had 20 functions back then. So if you're in VisiCalc, one of the functions is at sum. And we want to sum from this cell. I press the period down to that cell, closing paren. All right, so it feels a little similar. But in those 20 functions, they did not have an if statement. They did not have VLOOKUP, but they did have LOOKUP. And LOOKUP was very interesting. I actually think that you're going to end up using LOOKUP in VisiCalc more often for if-then statements. Like, I want to check and see if column B is greater than or equal to 80. The heading there isn't right, so we're going to use at lookup, open paren, and we want to look up the value to the left of us, comma, and the lookup table can either be one column or one row. It goes down or across. So we start at that point and go to that point. All right, and what it does, it automatically returns the value. If it's a column, it returns value to the right. If it's a row, it returns the value just below. So this is going to cruise down through here. It's going to find the 0. It's going to see the 80. It's going to give us the value of 0 because it's not greater than 80. Now, in the next one here, let's just try it out here. We will change this to 88. See that then it returns the value greater than or equal to. So it's doing kind of the true version of the lookup, but only allows for a two-column table. And I actually, again, as I mentioned, I think this is going to be something that we're going to use more often for an if statement. So I'm going to do slash R here to replicate. That's the source range. The target range is going to be from that cell, period, down to this cell. And then check this out. What they're doing is they're going through the formula that I'm copying, and for each part, they want to know if it's a relative reference or no change. So right there, B2 is relative, so I'll press R. The F2, the top of the range, is no change, so N. And the bottom of the range is no change. So and there we get our answers, right? That very first lookup function. Now, this was programmed by Dan Bricklin and Bob Frankston. I actually talked to Dan Filstra, who was or emailed with Dan Filstra this week, who was president of VisiCorp. He said that they had lookup. It wasn't until Lotus 1.2.3 that VLOOKUP came around, and again, exchanging emails with Mitch Kapoor and Jonathan Sachs, and Jonathan says, as far as he knows, he is the inventor of VLOOKUP. So for those of you who love VLOOKUP, here's a look back at the very beginning, the very first spreadsheet, VisiCalc, and how they implemented lookup. By the way, the first example I did for this was a grade book where we had 0 to 64 is an F, 65 to 69 is a D, but it returned all zeros. This lookup can only return numeric values, so you couldn't return the letter grade A, B, C, D, and so on. Great look back into history. I want to thank everyone for who participated in VLOOKUP week. We obviously struck a chord, lots of interest. And that was lots of great articles from across the web. Great to see you. We'll have to do it again next year. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.